I am Dr. Judy Song, and I am an attending radiologist and current section chief of breast imaging at MedStar Georgetown University Hospital. My patients are both symptomatic and asymptomatic women who come into the Betty Lou Ourisman Breast Center and also at our satellite offices in the MedStar system in the Washington, D.C. area. The asymptomatic women who are coming in for their screening or routine mammograms are patients who are coming in to have mammographic evaluations, which are x-ray examinations utilizing our most current technology, which is our 3D mammograms, to evaluate their breast to look for indolent or early disease before it is causing any symptoms or before it's clinically manifest. In the field of breast imaging and breast cancer diagnosis and treatment, we have made great advances in recent decades. Some of the most relevant advances in my field have been the advent of 3D mammography or breast tomosynthesis, which was approved by the FDA in 2011 and which allows us to take a more in-depth look at women's breasts by acquiring scans over a arc, and so we get a volume of images of which we can then reconstruct, and therefore it allows us to flip through the pages of a book rather than looking at the six sides of a book. Other advances include the developments involving breast ultrasound, including potential automated systems that are out there, and breast MRI. At the Ourisman Breast Center, we are very fortunate to not only physically be located at one site, so patients can come in and see their radiologist, their surgeon, their oncologist, and their plastic surgeon all in one visit, but more importantly, we all work and collaborate so well together so that we are often discussing patient cases and making sure we get input and thoughts from one another. And as we all know, multiple heads are better than one when it comes to coming up with solutions and treatments. We know that screening mammography has been shown to decrease breast cancer deaths by up to 30 to 40% following most recent studies. And I think that's fascinating, to be able to find disease in someone who's not having any symptoms of that disease and to treat and cure them before it affects their lives in the long term and affects their lifespan. I think that's probably one of the most rewarding things out there. A mammogram is a low-dose x-ray examination of the breast. In our modern time today, and at the Ourisman Breast Center, we use the most cutting-edge technology, so we do what we call 3D mammograms, which allow us to image the breast in a very short period of time, and we obtain a great volume of data, which we then reconstruct into images and slices, which allow us to look through the breast, almost like flipping through the pages of a book, rather than looking just at the six sides. A 3D mammogram is a more accurate evaluation of your breast, and for the patient, takes just as much time, or as little time rather, as a 2D mammogram, and now with our current technology is offered at the same radiation dose. So it's more bang for your buck and allows us to get more accurate imaging of your breast. I think that is one of the fallacies about mammograms, that mammograms hurt. Mammograms are not by any means comfortable, but they are tolerable and they should not cause active pain. They do not actively hurt. When you prepare to come in for your mammogram, we ask that you wear a two-piece outfit, and that you do not wear any deodorant or any powder, and come in with a good attitude and understanding that you will be asked your name and your birthday and a lot of your history questions, such as your family history and any medications, multiple times. We want to make sure we're imaging the right patient and giving you the right test. We know that starting annual mammography at the age of 40 saves the most lives. So multiple organizations, including the United States Preventive Task Force, the American College of Radiology, the American College of Obstetricians and Gynecology, and the American Cancer Society, all advise that women be entitled to start their mammogram at the age of 40. We do have some disparate recommendations about when to definitively start your screening mammograms and how often to have those examinations, whether annually or biannually. And that stems from each organization's difference in judging the risk versus benefits and their interpretation of the clinical data that's available today. Women with dense breasts are women who have a higher percentage of fibroglandular tissue in their breast with respect to fat. Historically, imaging women with dense breasts was a little bit difficult. With the advent of 3D mammography, however, it's much easier to provide an accurate interpretation of these women's breasts because, as I mentioned, we're flipping through the pages and we'll be able to look through their breast tissue. Women with dense breasts are informed of their breast density because it is an important individual risk factor for developing breast cancer. Women with dense breasts are women who are born that way. You can't necessarily affect your breast density. Sometimes in patients, once they approach menopause and have a decrease in their hormone stimulus, their breasts can get replaced by fat. We have found that that does not happen all the time. And having dense breasts, while in itself, is an important thing to know because it is a risk factor for breast cancer. There really is not much that any woman can do to change their breast density. We know that 3D mammography benefits women across the board regardless of their breast density, but it has been found to be particularly helpful in women with dense breasts. We are finding more cancers at earlier stages, which is particularly significant in impacting patient survival and patient lifestyle. We use 3D mammography at our facilities because we know that 3D mammography is the best mammography imaging tool out there in the detection of breast cancer. 3D mammography is more effective in not only picking up cancers earlier, but also in helping us call back the right patients so we minimize our false positives, meaning that patients who do not have disease do not get called back for further evaluation, and we minimize the stress on those patients who may previously have been called back for findings that were not actually cancerous or precancerous. That's it. We are very fortunate here at MedStar Georgetown University Hospital to provide mammography interpretations by dedicated breast imaging radiologists. All of our radiologists are fellowship trained and all of us specialize in mammography, breast MRI, and breast ultrasound. So that is an important distinction to make. Not all radiologists are breast imaging specialists. And for all women out there, I would say that wherever you go, make sure your mammogram is read by a dedicated breast imager and a dedicated breast imaging fellowship trained radiologist. And here at Georgetown, we are fortunate to have 8 of them. Screening mammograms are examinations that are performed on women who are asymptomatic. They have no clinical symptoms and they have no signs of disease. Diagnostic mammograms are mammograms that are performed in patients who have symptoms. And these symptoms can vary from pain to skin changes, to nipple discharge, to palpable lumps, and focal tenderness. We also do diagnostic mammograms on patients who have a history of breast cancer within the past 5 years, and patients who had screening mammograms who have findings that we would like to work up further. For the patient, the difference between a screening and diagnostic mammogram is that for a screening mammogram, you come in, you get your four views, and you get to go home, and you wait for a letter from us or a phone call from us regarding findings that say, you're fine, come back in a year, or please return for additional imaging. Diagnostic mammogram appointments involve a patient coming in, getting all of their imaging done, and waiting while the radiologist looks at the images and makes their final interpretation. The diagnostic appointment may entail additional imaging, breast ultrasound, and at the end of the day with your diagnostic mammogram, you get to go home with your result. For patients who undergo a screening mammogram, there is a small percentage that may be asked to return. And this can range between 12 to 14%. Of those patients that return, the majority will be fine. In 1,000 patients, we will find about 4 to 5 breast cancers. So when you look at the numbers, we're talking about less than 1%. Having said that, there's a lot of anxiety and, quite frankly, fear when you're asked to return for additional imaging from a screening mammogram. At our institution, you will receive a letter, but more importantly, you will also get a phone call from our clinical coordinator. One of the exciting new advances in breast cancer diagnosis and treatment is the individualized, personalized medicine of one. We are now able to stratify each woman's risk for breast cancer using a number of different modeling tools. And once we can stratify your risk, we can provide additional supplemental screening examinations that can help detect cancer earlier in those patients that are at an elevated risk for developing breast cancer. Our imaging technologies available for supplemental screening include whole breast ultrasound and breast MRI. We have found that breast MRI is the most effective additional screening tool with the greatest sensitivity and specificity. And in patients who undergo supplemental screening who are at a higher risk for developing breast cancer, meaning that their lifetime risk is greater than 20 to 25%, the addition of MRI has been found to detect 14.7 more cancers in every 1,000 patients. And that is remarkable. If we can find cancers earlier, before they're clinically significant, and when they're smaller, we can treat them more effectively and help improve both the woman's quality of life and their length of life. When you come in for your mammogram, we will ask you a number of questions, including the medications you've been on, your prior surgical history, as well as your family history. We ask about your family history because we have found that women who have a positive family history of breast cancer, and we can divide that into a strong family history when it affects a first degree relative, your mother, your sister, or your daughter, or a still significant but weaker family history when it affects other family members. That family history is important because that will help stratify your risk of developing breast cancer. It is important to note, however, that in women diagnosed with breast cancer, less than 15% of women have a positive family history. So while it is an important piece of information to have for us radiologists as we interpret your mammogram, your ultrasound, and your breast MRI, it is by no means the only risk factor, and it does not necessarily predict that you will have breast cancer. So that is important to know. The Ourisman Breast Center and the breast cancer program at MedStar Georgetown University Hospital is truly unique in the world-class clinicians and researchers you have here. Your doctors will all be experts in their field. And more importantly, we are collaborative and compassionate. We all come to work every day with the same goal in mind, to make a difference in helping women who are diagnosed with breast cancer. And we all work together to make sure that that goal is achieved. Because we are all at one facility and on one campus, that allows us to easily collaborate. And our research is also on one campus. And that allows us to bring new technology that's at the forefront of breast cancer diagnosis and treatment into our clinical practice in a seamless manner. So the benefit of being all on one campus allows us to have a quicker bench to bedside approach.